Good afternoon, Terry Sater again from the WISN 12 newsroom. We have breaking news and update on a massive fire, 33rd and Fond du Lac. Let's go live to News Chopper 12, Matt Salemi.
Matt, if you can... We are on the scene here, and firefighters are actually pulling some of the materials out of the building. Now, let me turn the camera to the building as well. What we have is four active water towers right now pouring water on this fire. It looks like it's an auto salvage lot or some sort of auto repair business, and we'll zoom back in. They have actually started using some foam as well. What we do see in the piles of rubble here is that there are some tires and old car parts stacked up, and they're throwing some foam onto those areas now. While the water towers continue to dump water at the rooftop, I've seen good section. It looks like a whole section of this roof has already collapsed under the flames and the weight of the water, and crews continue to pour more water on it. At this point, it looks like they are starting to get the upper hand on it, but it looks like a good section of the roof has already been consumed. At this point, it looks like a multi-alarm blaze, and they are actually setting up two other water towers, four of them active already, and they're looking to hook up at least two more at this point. And it looks like they're situated to where they can actually get water at it from all angles. And at one point, as we were looking earlier, it looked like crews were actually inside of this connecting building, and there was a firefighter hanging out of one of these windows with a hose as well. In fact, you can still see him a little bit through the traces of smoke. He was also getting some water on it from the building level as well. So we've been watching him attack it at all angles so far, and it looks like they're finally starting to get the upper hand.
And Matt, it looks like there are a couple of homes or maybe even an apartment complex in the back of this massive industrial building. You can see a lot of property around there, other structures, and they were concerned about that at the beginning of this fire. I know, Matt, have you been able to see any risk to any of the surrounding buildings?
Well, it looks like, you know, it is a massive complex. As you can see, it stretches across the entire city block, and they have been looking to protect some of those other buildings. As you can see, firefighters have set up a defensive on the downwind side of it, making sure that this home here does not fall prey to some of the burning embers that might go. And there is a block of homes as well right on that same side of the street that they're watching and keeping an eye on. But at this point, it doesn't see any evidence that any of those homes have caught fire at this point, but they are keeping a close eye on that.
And Matt, this jump to from second alarm to a third alarm to a four alarm as this continued, we got a hold of an employee inside the building who very quickly told us, we're getting out of here, we're evacuating. So this apparently spread very quickly. This has been going on for maybe about 45 minutes. We have 12 News' Mike Anderson, who's on the ground. And I understand, Mike, that they've been trying to keep our live television crews ways away from this building, actually.
Yeah, they got us blocked off right here. We're about half a block away from the scene, so Matt had a better view than what we have here on the ground. This is a scrap metal company is what we understand, and we had heard earlier that the employees had been evacuated out. When we got here, it was a very intense situation as firefighters were still racing to the scene. They're kind of standing down a bit now, as you saw earlier from the video from Chopper 12. The fire has been beat down, and just some white smoke that we see. We did see it kind of flare up a little bit from our Skycam truck just a minute ago, but it looks like they've done a good job of knocking this thing down. And we haven't either had access to any of the employees who were inside there. We got a few people from the neighborhood who are starting to gather around, but it's not as intense as it was earlier when we got here about 20 minutes ago. Terry?
And Mike, we have some video from when this first started. One of our tower cams got a picture of that, and we're going to show it to you. Look at this massive fire right now. You see the flame shooting from the roof. And as you look before at those live pictures, you can see this is what they were dealing with when firefighters first arrived at the scene. Again, this is Scrap Core Wholesale Auto Wrecking Company at 33rd and Fond du Lac in the city of Milwaukee. We have several crews on the scene, News Chopper 12, and we will bring you the latest information coming up on 12 News at 5. I'm Terry Sater from the WISN 12 Newsroom.